Now that we've seen the nitration mechanism, let's talk a little bit more about this derivative we've made. Nitrobenzene is less reactive than benzene. Remember that positive charge on the nitrogen atom? Well, that is inductively electron withdrawing, and it pulls electron density out of the ring. Since benzene needs to use its electrons to react in electrophilic aromatic substitution, they are now less available due to this inductive effect. We call the nitro group a deactivating group because it deactivates the benzene ring toward further electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. We can also show how the nitro group pulls electrons by drawing resonance structures. We can actually use the conjugation of the aromatic ring with the double-bonded oxygen of the nitro group to show how electrons can be pulled out of the ring. Now we're just moving electrons around, so the molecule needs to stay overall neutral, and in this resonance form that we draw, we end up with two positive charges and two formal negative charges. Now, of course, this charge-separated resonance form is not the best resonance form for nitrobenzene, but it does contribute. Also, it gives important insight into nitrobenzene's reactivity. Looking at an animation of how this resonance occurs, notice that when a pair of electrons moves away from any one of the carbon atoms, we gain formal positive charge on that carbon. We can also represent the delocalization in nitrobenzene using a resonance hybrid. Resonance hybrids aim to combine all of these individual resonance forms into one structure. This is to better represent that the overall structure is made up of each of these resonance forms, that one resonance form doesn't exist at one time in a molecule. Any given molecule's actual structure is really an average of all of its resonance structures. When we examine our resonance forms, we see that the oxygen atom on the right-hand side always maintains its negative charge. So we can draw a formal negative charge on that oxygen atom in our resonance hybrid. When we look at the nitrogen atom, we see that it always stays with a formal positive charge. So in our resonance hybrid, it will maintain that positive charge. Now the oxygen atom on the left-hand side is sometimes double-bonded and sometimes single-bonded. So here we need to use a partial bond, a dotted bond, to represent that double bond. We'll also put a delta minus since it's not always formally negatively charged. The bond connecting the nitrogen to the ring is sometimes single-bonded and sometimes double-bonded, so we'll use our dotted bond convention here again as well. Now within the ring, each carbon atom is sometimes single bonded and sometimes double bonded. So we can draw dotted bonds within the ring all the way around the ring to represent this well. Finally, we can put delta positive charges on three of our carbon atoms that get a formal positive charge in one of our resonance structures. And that generates our resonance hybrid. We can see the significance of this analysis when we react nitrobenzene in an electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Electrophiles are positive, so these three carbon atoms with positive character are going to have a repulsive interaction with an incoming electrophile. Therefore, the electrophile is going to bond at one of these carbon atoms that does not have positive character. And we can show our electrophile bonding to just one of them in our reaction scheme. On a substituted benzene, we can define the position that a new electrophile attaches with respect to that group. The adjacent positions are the ortho positions. Next to those are two meta positions. And across from the group, there is one para position. So we can say that the nitro group is a meta director.